this is the body by itself. It is relatively a little larger than your average DSLR, but... Whoa, Assalamu alaikum, Namaste, Namaskara. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Sharon Zakaria. Boom! What's up guys, this is gonna be an amazing video because as you all have read in the caption already, I've bought myself a brand new DSLR. This is my first DSLR ever. So, this is going to be an unboxing video. I'm not too good at technical stuff. I'm not going to be showing a lot of videos and you know pictures that I've been taking, that I started taking with the camera. This is purely going to be an unboxing video of the contents inside the box. So stay tuned guys, because I'm going to show you all what is inside the camera next. Alright guys, I have the Canon 90D with me, and this camera is supposed to be my next best vlogging camera, because all these days and all these videos that I've been watching of mine have been constantly recorded using the GoPro Hero 5 Black. That is what I've been, that's what I'm using to record my video right now. So it is a big jump for me to jump, you know, to go from a GoPro Hero 5 to a DSLR, a Canon DSLR with such a big rating and such a big depth in the way it shoots. Basically, the 90D is a successor of the 80D, which was extensively used by a lot of vloggers. The 80D has been a monster among DSLRs in terms of video recording and photography among a lot of vloggers and other YouTubers in various aspects of the way they shoot stuff. So the 90D comes with Canon's latest top-of-the-line processor, which is the Rizik 8. And that is what is being used extensively on the new MCs and the other variants. So this camera basically has a really good battery life. It's supposed to have much more features compared to the 80D, and that's something that I'm looking forward to experiencing by using it. So let's quickly get into the unboxing bit. I don't want to waste too much of your time. So here we go. All right, so this is the box, the Canon EOS 90D. It has the Canon branding here. It says 1+1 2-year warranty. And it also has an extended warranty available for the second year, which we need to register by logging in to the website. And we have the EOS 90D here, and it says EFS 1855 IS STM. This is the kit lens that has been given by Canon for the camera. It comes with two variants. That's the 1855, and you can choose from another variant, that is the 18135. I chose to go with the 1855 because the camera, the body and the lens kit comes a little cheaper than the 18135, and the 18135 is not something that I would be using for a lot of reasons. For example, vlogging and photography and stuff. I would rather invest my money into some other lenses like the 50mm and the 1018, which is extensively used for the vlogging. And you have the bird's eye view of the camera here, and you have the front side view of the camera here. You have a 16GB card inside, and you have the Canon branding here as well, along with the EOS 90D branding. And here you have the key features of the camera. I don't know if you all can see it. It says 32.5 megapixel CMOS. Here we have the ISO level, that's at 25,600 on photography and 12,800 on the videography. Here we have the 4K recording. You have the dual pixel autofocus here. You have autofocus on eye detection. And you have the approximately 100% viewfinder, and the Wi-Fi Bluetooth connectivity options here. MRP on the box says it is for over 1,03,495 rupees, but I got it at a really good price of 90,550, and it's supposedly a good deal because there is a website called I Am A Student, which most of the vloggers recommend, which most of the people I personally know, you know, who buy stuff from the website, because they claim that I Am A Student offers the cheapest deals. So what was about 96,000 on I Am A Student, the store guys gave this camera to me at about 90,550, almost around 6,000 rupees discount. And that's really, really good for the price, because you would not get it for that price on any online website, any authorized or any genuine online website that Canon sells their products at. So let's open this box now and see what the contents are inside. So first of all, we have the paperwork here. This is the warranty card, the 2-year warranty card. You have the Canon branding and stuff here, and you have the owner's manual, or the instruction manual, as you can see. So we're going to keep this aside, and here you have Canon Imaging Academy registration, online registration form, where you can register and learn what the camera is all about. so we're going to keep this aside. And first up, we have a tray here, which has the EOS 90D branding on it. I think this is a strap for the camera. So this is something that I would definitely be using for the camera when I'm going to be walking around with it, or probably when I'm going to, you know, shoot a lot of pictures with it. And along with the strap, I can see that they've given the 16GB memory card free by SanDisk. It is the SanDisk Ultra 48MB per second 16GB memory card that comes free with the camera. So I'm going to keep this aside. Here we have the battery charger. The charger comes capable enough to charge one single battery at a time. This is what Canon offers. I did check with the store if they have a dual battery charger. They said no. So this is the only charger that's going to be available from Canon side, and you can actually opt for buying some third-party chargers, which I would not recommend because it might cause the battery to bulge and stuff like that. So it's not really recommended because by the company itself. So this is the battery that comes along with the box. This is a Canon LPE6N battery, and it's supposed to be of 1800 mAh range, a little less than your average iPhone. It's supposed to give a really good battery life, a really good range on the usage of the 90D compared to the 80D, because the 80D also used to come with the same battery. And because of the Rigigate processor, this battery gives a much more optimum performance on the 90D, which I'm yet to find out. So here we have the charging cable that connects the charger and the battery together. So we're going to keep this aside. We're going to keep this tray aside. So next up, we have another tray, as you can see here, and which I'm assuming is holding the lens, the 1855 lens, and the camera body. So this is the kit lens that comes along with the camera. So we're going to look into the body now. So this is the body by itself. It is relatively a little larger than your average DSLR, but I really wanted it to be a little big because I've got pretty big hands. I don't want the camera to feel very vulnerable on my hands. I don't want it to move around too much. So if you can see, my palm is pretty big. So I like holding onto my camera, which has a good grip. So this camera by itself has a beautiful grip, which I've found out after unboxing it, and it feels really good to hold it. It feels really good to, you know, to just keep on one hand and probably take a portrait shot instantly or a landscape shot, you know, as and when I like, because it does not feel too small in my hands. It does not feel like I'm going to drop it any moment, which I need to be extra careful of. And I like this, you know, this patch of material that they've given, the Canon has given here on the body. This is a complete aluminium built body, which I really like the quality of. It is no way plastic, and it feels very sturdy, and it almost is built like a tank. So that's what makes it very unique and nice. The best part of the 90D is that you have a lot of buttons to fiddle around with here. And what is different compared to the 80D is that it has a joystick control here, which is something that we're seeing for the first time. You can move around left, right, top and bottom, and you can go on cross angles, and you can also press to select. That's something new, and this has been retained from the 80D. To select your preferable choice from the settings menu, and you have the buttons here as well, which has a set button in between, and you have the zoom in and zoom out. So here we have a fully articulating screen, a fully touch enabled screen, which goes all round, and this is supposed to be really good for any YouTuber or any video creator or a content creator using the camera, because this is something that not every camera has. Because when you talk about Sony cameras like the Alpha series or the A7 R3 and cameras like that, you don't have an articulating screen, because you don't even know where you're looking at. You don't know what you're focusing on, you don't know what you're trying to record. All you know is that you have the lens pointing at your face, that you do not know if it's on focus or not. You have all your jack options here, this is the mic port. So you have a headphone jack here, and you have a mic port here, which just goes in directly along, you know, using a normal aux cable sized pin. And this is another jack, which I need to figure out what it is. And you have the HDMI slot here, and you have the Bluetooth connectivity slot here. This camera comes with inbuilt Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Then here you have the card slot, the memory card slot. What I really like about this camera is that the memory card slot is given on the side of the camera and not below the camera like the previous models of Canon and the other brands. it does not get into the way of your tripod, because if you have to change your memory card, all of a sudden you would probably have to remove your tripod, unscrew it, and then remove the memory card slot, open the memory card slot, and then take the memory card off. But here it's so much easier and so much more convenient that the memory card slot is given to the side, and you can just open it and shuffle between your memory cards as and when you like. And here you have the flash switch, which opens up like that, and you can just turn the flash on whenever you like. So let's try turning the camera on. I don't know if it has the required charge to turn this on, so let's just give this. Okay, so the battery does not have any charge in it, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to let the battery charge for a while and then try and turn it on and use it later. So for now, let's try getting the lens onto the camera and see how it looks and see how big the body actually is compared to any other DSLR that you would probably have at home. So let's try fixing this. So here we have, you just have a click and the lens is on. For now I'm actually recording using my GoPro. So the immediate next footage that you'll be seeing is going to be through the lens of my brand new Canon 90D. So here it goes. Alright guys, so this is the Canon 90D, and what you previously saw was the video that I was recording on my GoPro, and there's a lot of difference in the way I am actually looking with the DSLR compared to the GoPro, because this looks a lot more clearer and I can see myself in the the screen that's given in the camera. It looks fabulous because I'm not used to looking at myself on the camera. First thing, because GoPro does not have a flip out screen or anything as such, and I just point it at wherever I'm whatever I'm trying to show, and it starts recording. But this is like an entirely different experience. It's something so new to what I'm doing. I can't really figure out if y'all can hear me well, because I don't have a proper mic. I'm trying to use this lavalier mic that I've been using for my GoPro all along. I don't know how far this is going to fare, so if my audio is bad, do bear with me guys. It looks really good. I can see the megapixels coming into play, and I can see that the autofocus is tracking my face continuously and is not losing focus at all. And that's something that's really, really good. I cannot wait to start vlogging full-fledged with this camera. My hands are hurting because I'm not used to the weight at all. And I need to get a good mic, a good GorillaPod, a good tripod for the camera. Only then I need to start vlogging and I can, make some really good videos for all of you all. I hope you all liked watching this video. It's a very simple unboxing video, not like the typical stuff that you'll find on YouTube. Do mention down in the comment box below as to how this video was and what I need to improve on. Do follow me and check out all my other social media handles. It is given down in the description box below. And thank you so much for watching this video, guys. Do subscribe to my channel, like my video, and as always, stay safe, stay armored, stay protected.